teaching inmates how to grow sagebrush plants. We're actually growing 20,000 sagebrush plants that will be planted in an area just north of Quincy. It was a place that burned last year, so we're repopulating the burnt landscape with the sagebrush. The project is to plant habitat, basically, for a bird called the greater sage grouse. So the greater sage grouse, due to habitat destruction, is just about becoming an endangered species, and it actually eats sage. Working with the inmates is just really, it's a very fulfilling thing. Inmates normally that I work with have done a graduated from a sustainability program within the prison called Roots of Success, and they're just absolutely thrilled and excited to participate in any type of project that they can use their newly learned skills. They're desperate to do something during the day as they serve their time. But the other thing is that it's also a job for them. It's an economic incentive as well as an opportunity to learn about science.
Well, I would like to make it into a job when I get out, but if not, it'd be a hobby. I just enjoy watching them grow and live. In the beginning, we had a few issues. We're all new and didn't really know how much water to give them, how much sun they needed, but we worked through all that. I like why we're growing it, and to help the community and the sage grouse.
I don't plan on doing it for a career move or anything like that, but just a lot of different things I would like to do, like just for my own stuff at home, a garden at home and stuff. The wife actually does it, so it's just kind of nice to just know things. I'm one of the people like to know how to do everything.
One of the questions we often get is, why would you grow, sagebrush? Isn't that, just kind of everywhere? And often it is when we drive around in our communities, but in the past 100 years, we've actually lost about 50% of our shrub-steppe habitat. It's the first prison in Washington State to say, yes, we want this program. We think it's valuable for our inmates, and it just makes a lot of sense. It's a new section of the population that is stoked about conservation. They are learning about biology, ecology, horticulture. It's a job skill. So this is about job readiness.